Hi everyone, welcome to today's topic. Today's topic, we will see the epitope mapping, protein alignment and protein-protein docking by using the software as well as the protein data bank. So let us go into the literature and see what we are going to get from the literature of protein data bank. So from the protein data bank study, if you click on the RCSB, that is Royal Chemical Society of Protein Data Bank. So here, once you go to the site, you will get the information of proteins already in the literature. So now the protein of interest is 6W41. So just I am typing it. So once I click it, I will get the information of that protein of interest. So now if you see, the protein is crystal structure of SARS-CoV-2 receptor binding domain in complex with human antibody, that is CR3022. So this is the fundamental information of your the crystal structure of proteins which is binded with human antibodies, that is CR3022. So let us see one more protein of interest, that is 2DD8. So again, I am going into the literature. I am just searching it, 2DD8, and I'll click on to the information and I will see what exactly the information I'll get. Here, the 2DD8 is crystal structure of SARS-CoV spike receptor binding domain complexed with neutralizing antibodies. So here it is SARS-CoV, that is of SARS coronavirus, and the earlier it is SARS-CoV-2, that is novel coronavirus. So these two viruses are different because one came in 2012, the other came in 2019. So this is a fundamental information between two different protein parts of your protein data bank. So now let's see how the protein alignment and docking generally helpful. So let me take the protein of interest. That is, I'm simply importing the molecule of 3D. That is what I'm saying is 6W41 PDB. Just once I click this, what I will get here is a crystal structure. So let me close all the other. So I'm just simply closing all the other things. So just thing is, you need to align the protein of interest. So this is my protein. I will show you the list. I will close later on. So this is my protein of interest. So what exactly my protein shows here is, if you see here, that is the protein with the antibodies, heavy chain and light chain antibodies and ligands. So here what I am doing is, I am simply removing the the two antibodies from the protein. I have simply removed the antibodies. So once I remove, as well as ligands and everything. So now this is my simple glycoprotein of my spike receptor protein. So simply I'll right click and I'll go for align protein structure. Once I do that, so I'll just go to the align data, that is select molecular projects. Now here, what the protein I will select is 2DD8. So now I'll click it and I'll press OK. Once I'll click again, I'll press OK. By doing so, whatever the data I'll get, see here, this is a very, very interesting data. So this data shows you that the alignment of sequence, this is how the sequence alignment is, how there is alignment of data. So this is the fundamental information you need to know before going into any receptor docking studies. I will show you just a moment because of heavy load on my software. So this is there is some amount of hanging, so I'm just closing all the stuff. So here you need to know one thing is that is sequence alignment as well as motif and protein alignment. This is the fundamental information with which your docking plays a major role here. That is the fundamental information in your protein docking studies. So the basic information here is the how well the protein matches to your existing in the literature. See, someone says that this is a virus, is a man-made virus. Someone says that no, it is from the bats, it is from the coronavirus. So here there is a lot of ambiguity, but we do not believe in ambiguity and any verbal communication. We simply believe on the scientific data. So let us see the scientific data of the literature. Yeah, if you see, this is what the motif matching of two protein alignments, that is the alignment between the 6W41, that is spike glycoprotein of novel coronavirus, and this is the SARS coronavirus. This is the fundamental information, as well as let us see the information of sequence alignment. Yeah, if you see the sequence alignment, see there is a complete overlap between the sequence of SARS coronavirus as well as the coronavirus 12. So which highlights that the coronavirus, the probable ancestor, that is origin, is by genetic mutation. However, the mutation may be induced or it may be natural. So this is the fundamental difference how you will show the alignment features. So now I would like to tell you one thing, that now I would like to dock between two protein complexes. That is, if you see my let us see this protein 2DD8. So here the 2DD81 contains heavy chain and light chain epitopes or antibodies. Now I would like to dock these two light chain and heavy chain onto my 6W41 spike protein. For that, what I am doing is I am just exporting this into a PDB format, that is 2DD81. So whatever my PDB format, I will export onto my data bank from my desktop. Once I do that, I will go to a web server where I will initiate docking. So in between two proteins, so one motif and another motif, how they are aligned, how, what are the interaction between these two motifs, that is what they are interaction and how they are aligned between each other. So this is the fundamental information in the docking studies, which will tell you how to use a fundamental of a docking protocol. So let me tell you by another method. So let me go back to the web server. That web server is again your KBDoc. So I'm just going here. So I'm just click the KBDoc. In this KBDoc web server, just a minute. Yeah, this is my web server. Onto the web server, I'll upload my two, one is antibodies, the other one is my protein. So the antibodies correspond to SARS, which is in 2012 virus, and the protein corresponds to 2019, that is novel coronavirus. Now I will superimpose and dock between these two proteins. What are the interaction between these two proteins? That will give me an matter of interest whether it can be prepared for a vaccine or not. Now let us do that by simply go to the search page. Now here I will type between two domain structures. So simply I will click here So here it is asking me to upload the ProDB file. So I'll just click the my protein, which is that is simply I am selecting here 6W41.1PDB. So this is the protein which is modified, in which I have removed the antibodies from the novel coronavirus 19. So now I would like to select the only the antibodies which are of SARS coronavirus, which are present in already in the literature long back. Now simply by continuing here, I will get the information of docking between two protein molecules, how well they are interacting, how they are interacting with the antibodies, whether they have any sort of interaction or not. Let me check with the fundamental information. So this is my protein. So I will check with my heavy atom. So simply find, I will go for find templates and let me check what happens exactly. So here I will go and click find templates. Once I click the find templates, so see, there are interactions between the protein. That means that is this is the probable this is the probable vaccine candidate. It can be a vaccine candidate between your protein of interest. So this is a fundamental information. So what you get from a protein site, so how your interaction is also displayed here. See here how well the superposition of domain-domain interaction between spike protein and your receptor complex. So this is a binding domain of your proteins of interest. So let us see the other proteins also. So if you see the other heavy chain and light chain, so this is the data, that is PFAM structure data. What you get here is the SARS protein binding domain in contralex with neutralizing antibodies. So this is the fundamental information by with which you can know that the existing coronavirus candidate can be a vaccine for the new virus which has been originated from that. By this, we are explaining the protein-protein docking of two proteins, so which can interact and exhibit the interactions between them. So by this, I complete today's lecture of protein-protein docking. Hope you understand the lecture on how you find the fundamentals of protein-protein docking, protein alignment, protein sequence alignment, as well as protein-protein docking. If you like my lectures, subscribe and share among your friends.